Serve as signals of warning to those who would resent my being. O come forth in the name of Abaddon and destroy he whose name I giveth as a sign. O great brothers of the night, thou who makest my place of comfort, who rideth out upon the hot winds of hell, who dwelleth in the devil's fane, move and appear. Present yourselves to him who sustaineth the rottenness of the mind, that moves the gibbering mouth that mocks the just and strong. Rend that gaggling tongue and close his throat, O Kali. Pierce his lungs with the stings of scorpions, O Sekhmet. Plunge his substance into the dismal void, O mighty Dagon. I thrust aloft the bifid barb of hell, and on its tines resplendently impaled, my sacrifice through vengeance rests. Shemhamphorash.
Shemhamphorash.
Hail Satan.
Hail Satan.
Beijing, Beijing, Yad.
forth, O great spawn of the abyss, and make thy presence manifest. I have set my thoughts upon the blazing pinnacle, which glows with the chosen lust of the moments of increase, and grows fervent in the turgid swell. Send forth that messenger of voluptuous delights, and let these obscene vistas of my dark desires take form in future deeds and doings. From the sixth tower of Satan, there shall come a sign which joineth with those salts within, and as such will move the body of the flesh of my summoning. I have gathered forth my symbols and prepare my garnishings of the is-to-be, and the image of my creation lurketh as a seething basilisk awaiting his release. The vision shall become his reality, and through the nourishment that my sacrifice giveth, the angles of the first dimension shall become the substance of the third. Go out into the void of night and pierce that mind that respondeth with thoughts which leadeth to paths of lewd abandon. My rod is a thrust. The penetrating force of my venom shall shatter the sanctity of that mind which is barren of lust. And as the seed falleth, so shall its vapors be spread within that reeling brain, benumbing it to helplessness according to my will. In the name of the great god Pan, may my secret thoughts be marshaled into the movements of the flesh of that which I desire.
My bones are aflame, the dripping of the nectar from my eager cup shall act as pollen to that slumbering brain, and the mind that feels not lust shall in sudden reel with crazed impulse. And when my night of surge is spent, new wanderings shall begin, and that flesh which I desire shall come to me. In the names of the great harlot Babylon, and of Lilith and of Hecate, may my lust be fulfilled.
In the name of Satan, Lucifer, Belial, Leviathan, and all you demons named and nameless, walkers in the velvet darkness, all you dim things, twisted half-seen creatures, wraith-like, glimpsed beyond the swirling foggy veil of time and spacious night, draw near, attend us, we command you. Welcome a new mistress, Xena, creature of ecstatic magic light. With us say, welcome to you, child of joy, sweet passion's daughter, product of the dark and musk-filled night, ecstasy's delight. Welcome to you, sorceress and 3x3 blessed sister witch. Welcome to our company, the path of darkness welcomes thee. Be not afraid. Above you, Satan heaves his bulk into the startled sky and makes a canopy of great black wings. The many-footed walkers give to you their strength, the power of red fang and claw, and all the madly dancing demons fill you with the lost knowledge of ancient ones. Small sorceress, most natural and true magician, your tiny hands have power to pull the lion vault of heaven down
and from its shards build up a monument to your own sweet indulgence. Your power makes you master of the world of frightened, cowering, and guilt-ridden men. And so, in the name of Satan, we set your feet upon the left-hand path. Three times above the flame you pass, to kindle lust and passion in your heart, that the heat and brightness of Shambhala's flame may warm you, make you burn bright and passionate. Zena, we call you after the manner of Lucifer's enlightened name. In the name of Belial, with earth we place upon you Satan's mark, that you might not forget the dark, moist earth, the pit from which you came, the jetting stream of manhood fertilizing Mother Earth. Thus was it always, and to time's end will it be the same. Zena, we call you that your power too may last unending, always strong as man and earth. May they too be the same. In the name of Lucifer, with the brazen bell we baptize you with air, with magic shattering and changing all life's patterns, that you may find your place. This we do in demoness, first witch, sweet Galatea's magic name. In the name of Leviathan and with the great salt sea we finalize. May its power and your own be always the same, that all the gods that dwell within the watery abyss shall smile upon your being and swirl about you lovingly. And with those others in the devil's fame, you so will cause the heads of men to reel and spin. You too will fill them with desire, symbol of indulgence bound forever to the magic of your name. Zena, we baptize you with earth and air, with brine and burning flame. And so we dedicate your life to love, to passion, to indulgence, and to Satan and the way of darkness, fame. Hail Zena!
Hail Zena!
Hail Satan!
Hail Satan!
I bid ye rise and give the sign of the horns. Open wide the gates of hell. The lower heavens beneath you, let them serve you. Govern those who govern. Cast down such as fall. Bring forth with those that increase and destroy the rotten. No place, let it remain in one number. Add and diminish until the stars be numbered. Arise, move, and appear before the covenant of his mouth, which he hath sworn unto us in his justice. Open the mysteries of your creation, and make us partakers of the undefiled knowledge. Shemhamphorash.
Shemhamphorash.
Hail Satan.
Hail Satan.
Hail Satan.
Hail Satan.
Hail Satan.
Hail Satan.
Bickered and quarreled for an entire age of earth. Each of these deities and their respective priests and ministers have attempted to find wisdom in their own lives.
The ice age of religious thought can last but a limited time in this great scheme of human existence. The gods of wisdom defiled have had their saga, and their millennium hath become as reality. Each with their own divine path to paradise hath accused the other of heresies and spiritual indiscretions. The ring of the Nibelungen doth carry an everlasting curse, but only because those who seek it think in terms of good and evil, themselves being at all times good. The gods of the past have become as their own devils in order to live. Feebly they play the devil's game to fill their tabernacles and pay the mortgages on their temples. Alas, too long have they studied righteousness, and poor and incompetent devils they make, so they all join hands in brotherly unity, and in their desperation go to Valhalla for their last great ecumenical council. Draweth near in the gloom the twilight of the gods. The ravens of night have flown forth to summon Loki, who hath set Valhalla aflame with the searing trident of the inferno. The twilight is done. A glow of new light is born out of the night, and Lucifer is risen once more to proclaim, "This is the age of Satan. Satan rules the earth. The gods of the rotten are dead. This is the morning of magic and undefiled wisdom. The flesh prevaileth, and a great church shall be builded, consecrated in its name. No longer shall man's salvation be dependent on his self-denial, and it shall be known that the world of the flesh and the living shall be the greatest preparation for any and all eternal delights. Regi Satanas, Ave Satanas, Hail Satan!" In this arid wilderness of steel and stone, I raise up my voice that you may hear. To the east and to the west I beckon. To the north and to the south I show a sign proclaiming, "Death to the weakling, wealth to the strong." Open your eyes that you may see, O men of mildewed minds, and listen to me, ye bewildered millions. For I stand forth to challenge the wisdom of the world, to interrogate the laws of man and of God. I request reasons for your golden rule, and ask the why and wherefore of your Ten Commands. Before none of your printed idols do I bend in acquiescence, and he who saith, "Thou shalt," to me is my mortal foe. I dip my forefinger in the watery blood of your impotent man, Redeemer, and write over his thorn-torn brow, "The true prince of evil, the king of the slaves." No hoary falsehood shall be a truth to me. No stifling dogma shall encramp my pen. I break away from all conventions which are not those which leadeth to my earthly success and happiness. I raise up in stern invasion the standard of the strong. I gaze into the glassy eye of your fearsome Jehovah and pluck him by the beard. I uplift a broad axe and split open his worm-eaten skull. I blast out the ghastly contents of philosophically whited sepulchres and laugh with sardonic wrath. Behold the crucifix. What does it symbolize? Pallid incompetence hanging on a tree. I question all things as I stand before the festering and varnished facades of your haughtiest moral dogmas. I write thereon in letters of blazing scorn. Lo and behold, all this is fraud. Gather around me, O ye death defiant, and the earth itself shall be thine to have and to hold. Too long the dead hand has been permitted to sterilize living thought. Too long right and wrong, good and evil, have been inverted by false prophets. No creed must be accepted upon authority of a divine nature. Religions must be put to the question. No moral dogma must be taken for granted. No standard of measurement deified. There is nothing inherently sacred about moral codes. Like the wooden idols of long ago, they are the work of human hands. And what man has made, man can destroy. He that is slow to believe anything and everything is of great understanding, for belief in one false principle is the beginning of all unwisdom. The chief duty of every new age is to upraise new men to determine its liberties, to lead it towards material success, to rend the rusty padlocks and chains of dead customs that always prevent healthy expansion. Theories and ideas that may have meant life and hope and freedom for our ancestors may now mean destruction, slavery, and dishonor to us. As environments change, no human ideal standeth sure. Whenever, therefore, a lie has built unto itself a throne, let it be assailed without pity and without regret, for under the domination of an inconvenient falsehood, no one can prosper. Let established sophisms be dethroned, rooted out, burnt and destroyed, for they are a standing menace to all true nobility of thought and action. Whatever alleged truth is proven by results to be but an empty fiction, let it be unceremoniously flung into the outer darkness, among the dead gods, dead empires, dead philosophies, and other useless lumber and wreckage. The most dangerous of all enthroned lies is the holy, the sanctified, the privileged lie, the lie everyone believes to be a model of truth. It is the fruitful mother of all other popular errors and delusions. It is a hydra-headed tree of unreason with a thousand roots. It is a social cancer. The lie that is known to be a lie is half eradicated. But the lie that even intelligent persons accept is fact. The lie that has been inculcated in a little child around its mother's knee is more dangerous to contend against than a creeping pestilence. Popular lies have ever been the most potent enemies of personal liberty. There is only one way to deal with them. Cut them out to the very core, just as cancers are. Exterminate them root and branch. Annihilate them, or they will us. Love one another, it has been said, is the supreme law. But what power made it so? Upon what rational authority does the gospel of love rest? Why should I not hate mine enemies and hunt them down like the most vicious of all beasts that they are? If I love them, does that not place me at their mercy? Is it natural for enemies to do good unto each other? And what is good? Can the torn and bloody victim love the blood-splashed jaws that rend him limb from limb? Are we not all predatory animals by instinct? If humans ceased wholly from preying upon each other, could they continue to exist? Is not lust and carnal desire a more truthful term to describe love when applied to the continuance of the race? Is not the love of the fawning scriptures simply a euphemism for sexual activity? Or was the great teacher an emasculated milksop who glorified eunuchs? Love your enemies and do good to them that hate you and despitefully use you as the despicable philosophy of the spaniel that rolls upon its back when kicked. Hate your enemies with a whole heart. And if a man smite you on one cheek, smash him on the other. Smite him hip and thigh, for self-preservation is the highest law. He who turns the other cheek is a cowardly dog. Give blow for blow, scorn for scorn, doom for doom, with compound interest liberally added thereunto. Eye for eye, tooth for tooth, yea, fourfold, a hundredfold. Make yourself a terror to your adversary, and when he goeth his way, he will possess much additional wisdom to ruminate over. Thus shall you make yourself respected in all the walks of life, and your spirit, your immortal spirit, shall live, not in an intangible paradise, but in the brains and sinews of those whose respect you have gained. Life is the great indulgence, death the great abstinence. Therefore, make the most of life, here and now. There is no heaven of glory bright, and no hell where sinners roast. Here and now is our day of torment. Here and now is our day of joy. Here and now is our opportunity. Choose ye this day, this hour, for no Redeemer liveth. Say unto thine own heart, I am mine own Redeemer. Stop the way of them that would persecute you. Let them be hurled back to confusion and infamy, those who devise thine undoing. Let them be a shaft before the cyclone, and after they have fallen, rejoice in thine own salvation. Then all thy bones shall say pridefully, who is like unto me? Have I not been too strong for mine adversaries? Have I not delivered myself by mine own brain and body? Blessed are the strong, for they shall possess the earth. Cursed are the weak, for they shall inherit the yoke. Blessed are the powerful, for they shall be reverenced among men. Cursed are the feeble, for they shall be blotted out. Blessed are the bold, for they shall be masters of the world. Cursed are the righteously humble, for they shall be trodden under cloven hooves. Blessed are the victorious, for victory is the basis of right. Cursed are the vanquished, for they shall be vassals forever. Blessed are the iron-handed, the unfit shall flee before them. Cursed are the poor in spirit, for they shall be spat upon. Blessed are the death-defiant, their days shall be long in the land. Cursed are the God-adorers, they shall be shorn sheep. Blessed are the valiant, for they shall obtain great treasure. Cursed are the believers in good and evil, for they are frightened by shadows. Blessed are those that believe in what is best for them, never shall their minds be terrorized. Cursed are the lambs of God, they shall be bled whiter than snow. Blessed is the man who has a sprinkling of enemies, they shall make him a hero.
Cursed is he who doeth good unto others who sneer upon him in return, he shall be despised. Blessed are the mighty minded, for they shall ride the whirlwinds. Cursed are they who teach lies for truth and truth for lies, for they are abomination. Thrice cursed are the weak whose insecurity makes them vile, for they shall serve and suffer. The angel of self-deceit is camped in the souls of the righteous. The eternal flame of power through joy dwelleth within the flesh of the Satanist.
Das Lied von die satanische Reich. Ja, ja, alala. Trumpets are blaring, the times come round. Satan is here to claim his ground. There's an earth that's green. There's an earth that's free. There's a place for you and a place for me. But the bleeding hearts wouldn't let it be. We don't need them anymore. Let the lions and tigers rip them up. The arena shouts for Christian blood. Let them chew them up and spit them out. We don't need them anymore. Once there was a need for simple minds. Once there was a need to save men's souls. Fools had to be forced to stay in line. Preachers Bible could serve those goals with their holy writ and their cardinal sin. They could force their paper demons into a cardboard prison, a paper cell. They can't do that anymore. Is their cry. Even though tricksters make the law, justice is served by fang and claw. With their beaks of steel, see them slash askew righteous Christian, Buddhist, Muslim, Jew. They've become a plague. So let's start anew. We don't need them anymore. Drums out of the darkness. Listen well. drums beating like thunder, straight from hell. Reggae Satanas, the time's come round. Satan is here to claim his ground. With our morning star from the deepest night, smash the crumbling cross, for might is right. Let the shuffling zombies grope for light, and will reign forevermore.
We'll be right back.